In this graph, we'll look at the hormones of pregnancy and some of their main actions. We're going to graph the hormone levels on our y-axis here relative to the period during gestation, during pregnancy, on our x-axis. We're going to start over here on the left with fertilization. That's at time zero. And of course, at fertilization, the sperm and the egg meet to form the zygote. We immediately begin to undergo cell cleavage, increasing the number of cells in that early embryo. It will travel for about a week along that uterine tube via ciliary action. And at about that 1 week point, it will enter the uterine cavity and begin implantation in the endometrial lining of the uterus. Now, once that occurs, the outer cells that are allowing that implantation, aiding that implantation, these are the syncytia trophoblasts, they're going to produce a hormone called HCG. This is actually the pregnancy test hormone because it's released almost immediately upon implantation. But the functional purpose of this hormone is to save the corpus luteum. Remember, at the end of a normal ovarian cycle, the corpus luteum would undergo demise and our progesterone and estrogen levels would fall. They are not falling down here. And so we are saving that corpus luteum through the action of this HCG on LH receptors on that structure. Our progesterone, again, is helping maintain that endometrial lining. And so we do not undergo menses. Now, that corpus luteum will be maintained for about 10 weeks. And then we're going to get this luteal placental shift up here, where our progesterone and estrogen are going to start to come more so from the placenta than from the corpus luteum. The placenta is growing and growing, and it's producing these same hormones that the corpus luteum was. Again, maintaining the pregnancy through high progesterone and more moderate estrogen levels. Progesterone is anti-contractile of the myometrium layer. It's helping to avoid menses early, but then later on, it's just sort of helping to maintain a relaxed uterus. The estrogens, on the other hand, stimulate placental blood flow, very important to a growing fetus. They also stimulate growth of that smooth muscle layer of the myometrium, making the uterus wall stronger and stronger over time. And so those hormone levels are maintained till fairly late in pregnancy. And then we're going to start to see a shift. And in that shift, the fetus is starting to produce products that are going to enhance the transition from progesterone secretion to estrogen. You can see our estrogen becoming more dominant here. And the estrogens help coordinate the contractility of the uterine wall. They stimulate contractile factors. They stimulate connectivity of the smooth muscle via gap junctions. All that's going to lead to a uterus that's more sensitized to contraction and less relaxed. And so that the fetus itself, through signals from the adrenal cortex, is going to enhance that production of estrogen, decrease the production of progesterone, and increase the contractility and excitability of the uterus, ultimately resulting in childbirth.